Good morning everyone, thanks for being with me. So let me explain how to split a cake. No, sorry, I was joking. But actually how to virtualize GPUs using OpenStack Nova. So first, let me quickly explain who I am. So I'm Sylvain, I'm French, and I work for Rayer, I work for Red Hat as a senior software engineer since 6 years, I think. I'm also a Nova Core maintainer since 5 years. But before discussing how to split GPUs, let me explain how to use GPUs by another way, by using GPU pass-through. Maybe you already know about GPU pass-through, right? Or PCI pass-through if you prefer. It's simple. That's something that was supported by Nova since Havana a long time before. And basically, it's about providing directly a PCI device to an instance, passing it directly to the instance. So you have a one-to-one mapping in between a physical device and a virtual device. Here, in our case, a physical GPU and the instance GPU. What's also nice is that that's not only for GPUs, like I said, but for any kind of PCI devices, including network cards, for example, FPGAs, or SSL offloading specialist cards, like, for example, Intel Q80. That being said, there are some limitations or caveats if you prefer using PCI pass-through and GPU pass-through. First of those is that basically you don't have ways to monitor or introspect the hardware that you're passing to the instances because the kernel directly move it to the instance. So you have a lack of visibility. There are also security concerns with PCI pass-through and GPU pass-through. Basically, any malicious user could be reflash the PCI device. For example, think about FPGAs. If you punt a FPGA down to the instance, then any user could reflash it. For GPUs, any user could try to break it or overclock it just by using the NVIDIA driver. And for other cards, it will be the same problem. And last one, you have physical limitations. Of course, because of the motherboard, because of the PCI slots. But if you also know about PCI Express, you know that there are PCI Express lanes. Some CPUs only accept up to 40 lanes. So, If you have a GPU using 8 lanes, then you can imagine that you won't have lots of GPUs being able to directly call CPU itself. So you basically also have limitations per slot and per CPU. That's the reasons basically why hardware vendors try to create virtual GPUs. And let me explain, before explaining how to use that in Nova, how this works. So basically, it's about having more than one single virtual GPU per GPU. That's good. And what's also very good is that you can actually profile a number of virtual GPUs depending on the use case that you would like to get. For example, for the same physical GPU, you could have either one virtual GPU or more than 16. That really depends on the profile you would like to get for that GPU. I will explain that later. What you also need to know is that it's on Nova since Queens. About the use cases, you can imagine them. Given you can profile them depending on the use cases, either you can use that for VDI or for general purpose. Like for example, a user will want to either have a 3D desktop or a 2D desktop. Some others could prefer large frame buffers, while some others don't care. Some people, for example, for inference, would like to have to batch long-running GPU jobs, while some others would prefer to have large performance. How does it work in practice? So basically, you have a manageable host API that's basically done by providing a new kernel module. Every hardware vendor provides its own kernel module. So for the moment, this is only for NVIDIA and Intel. They both have a kernel module that then actually creates virtual GPUs, I would say. So what's nice is that basically that specific kernel module helps you also to introspect the hardware. Given you're not directly passing the GPU down to the instance, you have a way to look at the host OS, for example, about the performance of the GPU or about the number of virtual GPUs that were created. There are a few caveats that you need to know. At least there is one about the fact that given this is vendor specific, some ask for a license. That's the case for NVIDIA. And some other also ask for some specific product lines. And that's the case for both. So for example, with NVIDIA, you need to have a grid license with some specific hardware. Tesla cards, Volta cards, mostly. And for Intel, you need to have a Skylake architecture at least. And given all this is done by a kernel module, of course, you have some limitations by the module itself. For example, in case of NVIDIA, you can see those specific limitations. If you really want to use NVIDIA vGPUs, look at the NVIDIA documentation itself and look whether, for example, those limitations are still there or not. Maybe they're already fixed by a new release of the kernel module. I don't know, to be honest. I told about profiles, about GPU profiles, so think about the same physical profile is getting you a way to create different kind of virtual GPUs. For example, in this case, for the V100 PCI Express card, for one GPU, what you can do is to choose in between a profile that gives you a way to create one single GPU or to one single virtual GPU or to use another profile where you will be able to create 30 virtual GPUs. Of course, performance will be different, but that will really depend on what you want. Keep in mind that there is no way to have two different profiles for the same GPU. For one GPU, you need to think about the GPU type you would like to get. How does it work in practice within Linux? That's very simple. The Linux kernel now uses VFIO mediated devices, virtual function input output. So let me explain you how this works in practice. So this host has an Intel GPU. As you can see, it's a P30 GPU. So for using it, You need to ask the kernel to use gbtg. So this way, you have to use it. But then you also need to run the Intel kernel module, kvm gt, see it. As you can see, this kernel module will now create a new sysfs repository called mdevbus. And then you can see all the supported types. For example, here for this GPU, we have two types. So let me now show you for NVIDIA GPUs. That's a new terminal. So as you can see, for this different host, we have a 30D controller, a Tesla T4 GPU. Basically, you need to do the same as for Intel. You need to provide a kernel module. As you can see, NVO MDev. And then you basically have the same MDev bus repository. And for example, this GPU have more supported types, right? As you can see. So now that I explain how to see the supported types, let me discuss how to use Nova for it. Okay, so how to use it? That's very simple. You need to provide some configuration some configuration option, as you can see, and then create a flavor. See the virtual GPU documentation here, but let me now provide a depot. So now I have a terminal with an environment composed of one Nova controller and two compute nodes, as you can see. Each of them have a NVIDIA card, a Tesla T4, as you can see here for the first one, and for the second one, the same GPU card. So given there are many types, and I don't exactly know which ones, let me show you how to see them using the NVIDIA documentation. So look, for example, about Tesla T4 documentation in NVIDIA, and we can see that there are multiple types. But here, for example, we are interested by two different types used for inference workloads and training workloads. So for example, the T44C and the T48C. So let's want to create virtual GPU types for one compute using this type and for the other compute using this other type. So let's go back to the terminal and see how we are gonna use it. Okay, so basically I know the GPU types. So the easiest is to look at which NVIDIA number is actually having these types. So for example, here, this is the 319 type. But if I wanna do this for the other type, let me just show you that's basically the same. So for the other host, that's the NVIDIA 320 type, which is actually correct. So, as you may see, I actually created a new option in the Nova Compute configuration file. So for this host, I asked to use that specific type with this specific PCI address, which, if you remember, that's optional. That section is optional, but that's, for example, if you have multiple GPUs for this host, then you can specify a GPU type different in between each GPU. But basically, here you can see the PCI address here, and I basically did the same on the other host. Sorry about that. Just a typo. Yep, there it is. There it is. So as you can see, I asked the Nova Compute to use this specific type for this host, and voilà. Once you modify Nova Conf for every compute, then of course you need to restart the compute service. But then, after restarting the compute service, you can actually verify that then you have two new resource providers, each of them corresponding to a GPU. In my case, for this host, I can see this specific GPU, and for this host, this other GPU. And for example, when I look at this resource provider, then you can see that I can actually create four virtual GPUs for this GPU. What I also did, because since I had two different types for two different GPUs, I also wanted to make sure that some flavors will ask different types. So for this, the documentation says that you need to create a trait. That's what I did for this resource provider. So I manually created a trait named Custom NVIDIA 319 that gives you a way to say, okay, this one supports this specific type. And the same goes for the other GPU. I mean, I can only create two virtual GPUs with this other type, and accordingly, I can see it on the trait. Remember that you have to manually create the trait. Then the documentation says, okay, then you have to provide a new flavor. That's what I did. I actually created two flavors for my environment. And what I had to do is to ask for that flavor to create one virtual GPU with this flavor, with this specific trait. So if I wanna create an instance having one virtual GPU supported by this type, that's how you make it. And that's pretty the same for the other, right? You can basically see the difference in between those two. The only difference is about which specific kind of GPU you would like to create. Then I'm actually happy to say that you made all the work, because then you can ask your users to just use the flavors that you created in order to generate some instances. So in this case, I want to create a new instance with that specific flavor. So I will use a GPU for the other compute, right? With a CentOS image, which is a bit tuned because I had to install the NVIDIA driver itself. Let me actually issue this. cool. So I now have a new instance. Let me check whether the instance is there. Great. So the instance is active. As you can see, the host is the correct one. There is no scheduling issue. You can see the spec itself. So you know what? Let's go and check the instance itself. But in order to make it, I will just use a floating IP. So I will just attach a floating IP because then it will be easier for me to check it. Okay, so the instance is booted. Let's connect to the host. Yaha, yes. And then see. Wow, that's nice. Remember that I asked to use that specific type. Indeed, there it is. And then you have the virtual GPU, which is within the instance. Last but not the least, remember that I also created another instance with another GPU with that other type. So if, for example, I look at the host OS, not within the instance, but at the host OS, remember when I was talking about monitoring, as you may see, that I can see the T4 with one single virtual GPU created. So you can basically introspect it, right? And on the other compute, you can also see the virtual GPU. So I had one instance running on that host with one virtual GPU attached. And on the other compute, I also had one instance with another GPU type. I hope that this demo helped you to exactly understand how this works with OpenStack Nova. But let me briefly explain the next features for that and what we'd like to see for next cycles. So what would be next for virtual GPUs in Nova? Of course, we have a few bugs. You can look at the documentation. I provided all the non-issues. A few of them, not a lot, but still. Some operators also would like to have a specific quota class, of course, because that's a new resource. Some others also would like to have some new affinity with CPU resources. Sometimes because of some stuff, they would like to make sure that they don't have any performance problems. That's a big feature to do, but we are trying to do it. And the last one is about live migrating virtual GPUs. The problem that we have is that for the moment, KVM doesn't really support live migrations. So once it will be done, then hopefully Nova will support it for the next cycles. That's it for my session. So if you have some questions, ask for me. Thanks.